Mayor Joseph Petty, and all distinguished guests this evening. Thank you for being with us as we celebrate our 103rd anniversary. In addition, we're celebrating the 150th birthday of this organ, and I thank Marl for stepping up to the plate and playing it for us. You did a beautiful job, Marl. We're here for the installation of President Dave, our officers and directors, the assistant governors, and myself. It's an honor for us to be present with you here together as we embark on continuing the valuable work of Rotary International. As you all know, our founder, Paul Harris, began Rotary with only three colleagues back in 1905. The four men rotated their meetings from their own offices, hence the name Rotary. Their first outreach project was really bathrooms or comfort stations for the city of Chicago. In their wildest dreams, those four gentlemen could never have imagined that 109 years later, Rotary would be the largest service organization in the entire world. Today, we have 1.2 million members in 200 countries and territories, with more than 33,000 clubs worldwide. And aren't we proud right here in Worcester that we are the 51st club of those 33,000. Our current leader, Rotary International President, Gary C.J. C.K. Wong, hails from Taiwan. His theme for this year is Light Up Rotary, and he bases his theme on the words of Confucius. Confucius said, it is better to light one candle than it is to sit and curse the darkness. Today, Rotary is lighting candles as we focus on six areas of focus. First, peace and conflict resolution, disease prevention and treatment, water sanitation and hygiene, maternal and child health, basic education and literacy, and economic and community development. Isn't it remarkable that 109 years later, we are still building clean bathrooms in developing areas of the world? That's a tie into one of our areas of focus, water sanitation and hygiene, also known as WASH. That leads us to another one of our areas of focus, disease prevention and treatment. As you all know, Rotary's signature focus and worldwide project is the eradication of polio. Here to give us a brief overview of Polio My Life is our very own Worcester Rotarian and physician, Dr. Don Dupre. Please help me welcome Dr. Dupre.
Symptoms may include fever, nausea, headache, flu-like symptoms, or stiff neck and back and pain in the limbs. A few people will become paralyzed, perhaps only 1% of all people who come down with a polio infection. Most of the time, it is a very mild, almost unrecognizable minor illness. There is no treatment, however, to reverse the paralysis of polio. Some people who've had polio develop the post-polio syndrome many years later. The symptoms include tiredness, new muscle weakness, and muscle and joint pain. There is no way to prevent or cure the post-polio syndrome. The polio vaccine has wiped out polio in the United States and most of the countries. The polio vaccine is inert, so you cannot catch polio from receiving the vaccine. The vaccine contains a dead, inactive form of the polio virus. There are actually three different strains that the vaccine has to cover, and the vaccine cannot cause polio. After receiving the vaccine, the body mounts an immune response to inactivate the polio virus if the person is exposed to a subsequent. As a result, the person is very unlikely to get sick from polio. Polio no longer occurs in the United States, but it remains common in other areas of the world. Because global travel can spread the disease, getting vaccinated against polio is still important. And one of the reasons I joined Rotary back in 1983 was because of the emphasis on international peace and development and the Polio Plus campaign. So I'm very proud to be a Rotarian. Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you, Don. The eradication of polio is a really lofty goal. And as I said, clean water is essential to that. And I want to acknowledge past District Governor Ed Hall, sitting at table number two. He, as past District Governor, brought over $500,000 worth of clean water projects to Haiti. He's been there 8 times, and sometimes he even fixed the well personally. And he... He's one of our heroes. So no other service organization besides Rotary has ever embarked on such an audacious goal as to eradicate polio. If you think that attaining our goal is easy, or inexpensive, or safe, think again. We have worked on this effort for over 20 years. Current projections indicate that we may reach our goal by 2018. And no, this goal has not been easy. It is not inexpensive, and sometimes it is not even safe. From day one, the eradication efforts have been challenging and most costly. Tragically, some of the workers who were dispensing the IPV, inactivated poliovirus vaccine, were murdered in Pakistan and Nigeria. It is a credit to each and every one of the people in this room and each Rotarian in the world that we are not giving up this fight to end polio. We are going to continue to raise the millions of dollars that it will take to eliminate poliomyelitis off the face of the earth. We're going to continue to send volunteers to remote areas of the earth to inoculate children and give them a purple pinky to prove they've been inoculated. Most of all, we are going to continue to light candles instead of cursing the darkness. Together, we can light up